You have overcame a lot in this life. You got put into unnecessary drama. People try to set you up. People try to do things to you. People try to humiliate your name. People purposely tried to get you fired from jobs. But yet, they thought they were smarter than you. But you already knew what these people was about to do before they did it. Because you had the voice of the Holy Spirit guiding you and give you spiritual discernment on these individuals. See, these people think they're smarter than you because you're a good person. They think their wicked, evil ways is going to get them in a good place with God. No. Being evil and wicked and plotting against somebody's life does not get you in a good place with God. These people had to send gangs of people after you just to try to check you, correct you, and you ain't even doing nothing wrong to nobody. You just literally, you go to work, you mind your own business, you do what you're supposed to do, and yet these people coming for you because this person wants to lie to them about you just to get you caught up in some drama, some mess, to get you terminated from your job. Not only to get you terminated from your job, but to just make your life a living hell. These people want you in some drama. These peers that you grew up with. Try to start stuff with you at school. Try to bully you while you just sitting there minding your own business. And think you wasn't going to catch on to their drama. Knowing that they had weird energy. These people knew they had weird energy. And they came around you, you minding your own business. Probably picking, just sniffing on flowers. And they just figuring out ways to plot against you. But you still rose and became a shining light in front of everybody. You considered a wise person to the heaven's kingdom. You're very wise before your years. But yet these people that plotted against you think they're smarter than you because they think you don't know the plot that they're doing. Of course they don't know you don't know because they don't know the Holy Spirit working behind you. See, the Holy Spirit lets you know everything. He talks to you in your dreams and visions. You get dreams about people that's plotting against you and people that the Holy Spirit tells you to look out for through spirit. It's called spiritual discernment. This is what these people don't understand. They don't know that you got God on your side. See, they be thinking you by yourself. They think you ain't got nobody. They think you ain't got nobody watching over you. They don't think your Heavenly Father's watching over you because they think, oh, well, this person got to be an easy target. They ain't got nobody around them. They're by themselves. We got all these people around us that's on our side, but they by themselves. But what they don't know is that God uses you to set them up. God uses you to set these people up. They think you by yourself, but yet you already a spiritual warrior for the heavenly kingdom. So God purposely puts you in certain situations and environments to get these people with a spiritual ass whooping that they need. This is what these people don't understand about you. Just because you're by yourself, that doesn't mean that you're not a fighter spiritually and that you don't get spiritual downloads straight from the heavenly kingdom about these individuals that's plotting against you. This is why they always defeated when it come to you being by yourself, and they shocked that you always know their every move before they do it, because God already whispered in your ear about this individual or about these group of individuals or about these co-workers. God already letting you know through gut instinct, through your feeling, through that gut feeling that you have, your intuition. See, these people are not aware that you have intuition and that God visits you every night to let you know what people plotting against you on. God already lets you know what people be on. But yet these people think you're by yourself, think you don't know nothing, think you're not, they think they're smarter, but really they're dumber than you. You have a spirit of intelligence. God gave you the gift of intelligence. But yet these people are deceived because they think you by yourself. You already knew what they was plotting. This is why when you sting them so hard, it bites them so hard, it hurts. Oh, it hurt these naysayers. Well, How did they know about the plot, these people think? How did this person know about our plan? We didn't tell them nothing. You don't need them being evil to tell you nothing. They're being evil and wicked, and God has given them a whooping about you. So he puts you in a way because they used to doing this to people. They used to messing up people's lives for whatever reason they want to do it for their promotion, for their popularity, for their fame. So they willing to throw an innocent person like you under the bus. They willing to throw you under the bus, but still wondering why you still rise and come out on top over them. Well, do these people not know that goodness always will overcome evil? See, being wicked and evil won't get you in a high position. No, that's good. You might get there for a moment from you being wicked, but you will be chopped down as sure as you thought, blink your next eye. As soon as you blink, God will chop you down because you came against one of his anointed ones. See, these people didn't know you were anointed. No, they were deceived. They thought you was a nobody. Like, we can do what we want with this person. We can do what we want. This person is a nobody. They ain't got no friends. They ain't got no family around them. So we can plot. We can do what we want. We can ruin their life. We can take their money. We can do their job. But they don't know that God is watching over you. And you was a test to see how they was going to behave. And they behave in a worse way when it came to you. These people behaved horribly. And that got recorded in heaven. He said, God saying, because he got a little smarter than your enemies. He said, okay, they've been doing this, but I'm going to send my child their way. This is my anointed one. Her name is Elizabeth. This is my anointed one. Her name is Sarah. This is my anointed one. Her name is Hadassah. They're sweet. They're nice. This is my anointed one. His name is John. This is my anointed one. His name is Jeremiah. I'm going to purposely send them these people's way because they being wicked down there on earth, this group of people or this individual. And I'm going to see how they act with this person. Little did they know they was being tested. You were their test. And for some reason, they failed the test again when it came to you. But yet they thought they were much smarter than you. And they thought they was going to get away with it because they got away with these other people that wasn't anointed like you. That's why you can't play with the anointed. See, God don't show these people. You got to have a spiritual eye to know when people are anointed. You are God's anointed holy one. That's who you are. These people think that you just by yourself. You got heavenly angels that follow you everywhere. They will mess up these people's lives for messing with you. And just because it don't happen the next day, that don't mean it's not going to happen. God will mess up these people's lives for coming against you as his anointed one. So while they thinking they smart, they really dumb when it comes to you because you already know their move by the power of the Holy Spirit. This is not checkers. This is chess. You've been playing chess for over 15 years now. You got a mind like the chessboard. You make the right moves while they making the wrong moves. And wonder why you are in that high royal position when these enemies and these people try to constantly come against you or these co-workers or whoever they send your way to get you tripped up in some drama. And yet you come out on top every time. Goodness will always prevail. So these people are getting a rude awakening about you as a person. Righteous will always prevail over wickedness. Righteous is smarter than the wicked. Y'all ever seen a dumb criminal? Most of the times on movies, they show dumb criminals that they really dumb and don't have any intelligence. Well, that's how it is with the wicked and people that do evil that try to plot against good people's life. They are dumb. On the spiritual level. And God know what they about to do. And that's why they get caught up every time. And you always come out on top. With the prize. With the trophy. Because you wasn't behaving. In wicked behavior. Like them. You wasn't plotting and scheming like them. To get them on the bottom. And God said he is proud of you for that. Keep walking in righteousness. Do not be like evil people. Be good and righteous, because you got a Holy Spirit that's in you, that the Holy, that the Heavenly Father put in you for you to accomplish your mission on this earth around all these evil people. Keep forward in faith, keep being righteous, and your reward will be big in heaven. This is what these people didn't understand. They're not smarter than you. They're not smarter than you. They only showed how foolish they really were when it came to you, because they want to plot and be wicked. They wanted your attention, but in the wrong way. And now God is dealing with them. And your elevation is here, and they can't do nothing about it. Bless his holy name. Bless the Heavenly Father. How can you mess with a person that's not bothering you? How can you mess with a person because you think they by themselves? That person might be an angel of God, might be his greatest warrior, and will mess your life up for messing with them because they got the anointing of God on their life. Be careful who you mess with, and be careful who you think that you can play with, because you don't know who's God's anointed, chosen one. And that's the prophetic message I got for somebody on today. If you reach to the end of this video, God bless you. Happy Friday, everyone. Happy Friday. We headed into the Sabbath, but happy Friday this morning. And if you like the content, please like, comment, and subscribe, and share with somebody that you know that possibly need to hear the message. Y'all keep moving forward in faith, good people. And don't worry about these evil, wicked people that's plotting on you without cause. Until next time, family. Bye-bye.